welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to be doing a celebrity inspired makeup look for you guys today. I did not watch the AMAs last night, but on Instagram, this photo was popping up all over my feed and it was all over the Explore page on Instagram as well. I thought this look was absolutely gorgeous. Selena Gomez looked absolutely beautiful, breathtaking, and I feel like her look was just so elegant and simple, yet she was the star of the show. I thought her makeup was on point, her outfit was on point, it was just amazing. So I knew I wanted to go ahead and recreate her makeup look for you guys today because I think she is just absolutely gorgeous, and in my opinion, I feel like Selena Gomez can do no wrong. I do not know the exact products that were used on her. I know that the makeup artist that did her makeup actually said that they used all Chanel products. I only have 3 Chanel products, which I actually used here in this tutorial, but whatever you have, of course, will do just fine. Everything else with the eyeshadows and other face products, I just completely elaborated, did it myself. I have no idea what they used exactly. I'm very happy with the way it turned out. I think it does look very similar to her look, and I just feel like, again, it's just really simple, really elegant, and even though this is a celebrity-inspired look, I feel like this is also perfect for the upcoming holidays if you just want to keep it very simple and minimal, or if you're not a person that really likes to do crazy, elaborate things for the holidays, I think that this is definitely the perfect look for you. So I hope you guys enjoy this tutorial. If you do, please make sure you give it a thumbs up and also subscribe to my channel if you aren't already. I love you all so much and I'll see you in my next video. Bye guys.
Alright guys, so I already went ahead and primed my eyes. So first we're going to go in with the Kat Von D Shade Light Eye Palette for this look. I'm going to take the shade 3 in from the left, and this is going to be our brow bone highlight. So I'm taking my Sigma E57 brush and pressing that right underneath my brow, and then as you'll see in a second, I'm going to go ahead then and blend it down into my eye to start off this look. You guys know I always start with my brow bone highlight and then go in with the transition shade. So then I'm going in with the shade all the way to the left, the brown. So again, that's going to be our transition shade, and I'm taking my Sigma E35 blending brush, and I'm just going to go back and forth in windshield wiper motions as well as circular motions, and I'm going to go ahead and flick out the outer corner because seeing Selena's eye look, you could see that a lot of shadow was kind of really pronounced in the outer corner of her eye. So I'm just going back and forth and making sure that the shade is really nice and blended as well as putting it in that outer corner. Then taking this really nice warm kind of rusty bricky shade, I'm going to go ahead with my E25 blending brush and really mainly put the main pigment in the outer corner. Even though I'm blending it into my crease, I'm mainly putting everything in the outer corner because I saw a lot of color in her outer corner, really warm color. So I'm mainly, like I said, putting this in the outer corner and just really blending it out, and then going back with my E35 brush, again, making sure that everything is nice and blended. Next, I'm going to do a combination of these two shades right here, and also with everything with these shadows, I'm just going very, very lightly. I'm really just going in with a little bit and then tapping off the excess. I'm just going to put this in the outer corner just to add a little bit of definition and warmth, more warmth to this look. This brown, the brown that I mixed in, is really going to give more definition to that outer corner, so you can really make sure that the eyes are more pronounced, and that's just how I love doing the eye looks, and I really thought it was a good idea. Then for our lid shade, I'm going to go in with the Naked Urban Decay palette, the number one, and I'm taking the shade Smog right there that I'm pointing to. I'm going to be using my Sigma Lid Shader Brush. This is the E56. Oh my gosh, I love this brush. It puts on the shadow like no other, as you can see. It's so... I love it. Love it, love it, love it. So I'm just going to go ahead and apply that all over the lid. I just saw in the pictures that Selena's eye look was very warm. It was a little bit bronzy, so this was the first eyeshadow that I thought of to use. So I'm just going to apply it all over the lid, and then going back with my E25 blending brush with no additional product on it, I'm just going to go ahead and blend the lid shade into my crease, just making sure that it's really nice and blended and there are no harsh lines as always. I'm going to take a mix of those two browns just a little bit and add it right to the outer corner just to add a little bit more warmth the look. That step is optional, you don't need to, but I just wanted to add a little bit more warmth. Then to prep our eyes for false lashes, I'm going in with the Galactic Mascara. It really looked like Selena wasn't wearing any lashes at all, so of course you can just go in with mascara and be done with it, but for me, my lashes are not the longest, so I am going to put on falsies. I'm using the Velour Lashes in Wispy Sweet Nothing and apply these onto my eyes. I just felt like these were really beautiful, really fluttery like always, and I feel like these just look really, really natural. My other option was to go in with with the Ardell Demi Wispies because they're more short and they do look more like natural eyes, but I really love the Velour lashes, of course, so I went with these. Then for my skin, I'm first going in with my LC Cosmetics Glow Enhancer. Her skin was so glowy, so I really wanted to amp up and vamp up and go crazy with the glowness for my skin, so I'm going in and putting this down on my skin first. This is really great for skincare as well. I always love using this. For primer, I'm going in with my Becca Backlight Primer, and I'm going to go ahead and apply this all over. This gives such a really nice, beautiful, natural glow to the skin, so this was definitely my go-to primer. For foundation, I'm going in with my Chanel Perfection Lumiere Foundation. Like I said, you can go with any foundation that you want, but because they did use Chanel products, I thought I would use my Chanel products that I have in my collection in this video. So I will be using them on the face, you'll see in a second. So I'm putting that all over and blending it out with my Morphe Beauty Sponge. For concealer, I'm going in with my Becca Aqualuminous Concealer. This is in the shade Light. She didn't have much of a crazy highlight, so that's why I'm keeping it very minimal. In the sense of I'm just kind of keeping the concealer to like a shade or two lighter than my foundation. I didn't want to go crazy stark white under the eyes because that's not what Selena had. And I'm just going to go ahead and make sure that that all is blended out. This step is optional, but my skin was feeling so dry. And then again, to go in with a little bit more of a luminous effect, I went with my Tatcha Dewy Skin Mist. And I sprayed that all over. It was just an added step, a little bit more glow, a little bit more luminosity, but my skin was feeling really, really dry. My next Chanel product is going to be the Soleil Tandé Chanel Bronzing Base. I'm using my Sigma F88 foundation brush, and I'm taking this and I'm going to go ahead and bronze up my face using this product. This has always been one of my favorite bronzing products, but Selena's face was so bronzed and it was so gorgeous. So I really wanted to use this as a bronzing base, again, going in with another Chanel product. If you just use powders to bronze up, that will give you that same effect. But again, I just really wanted to bronze up the face to the max, as well as use the Chanel product. And then after I put that down, I'm going back with my Morphe blending sponge just to go ahead and make sure that everything is nice and blended together so there are no harsh lines as always. Then we're gonna go ahead and start to set everything. So I'm going in with my Laura Mercier Translucent Powder. You guys know it is my favorite powder of life. So I'm gonna go ahead and press on my concealer just to make sure there's no creasing. And then going in with my Sigma F35 Tapered Highlighting Brush, I'm gonna go ahead and set the under eye concealer so there is no creasing. No nothing, everything is set, and that is how I usually set my under eyes. I'm going to go ahead and set my smile lines as well as my forehead because those are the areas where I do get a little bit oily, and my smile lines are always my number one concern because they crease like crazy. And then to set the rest of my face, you can go ahead and use Laura Mercier if you want, but I went in with my Chanel powder, again, just to use a Chanel product, and I will leave it linked down below for you guys. I do love this powder. I feel like it gives a really, really nice finish to the skin, and I really loved the way my skin looked at the end of the day. For brows, I'm going in with my Anastasia Brow Definer in Soft Brown. Selena and I have very similar brow shapes, so I am just going to go ahead and do my brows like I normally do, but the only difference with Selena and I, which I wish I had this, is the fact that her brow hair was probably like 5 times more. She probably has so much more brow hair than I do, I could see in the picture. So my brows aren't going to look as natural as hers because I do have to outline them, and then I fill them in with my Sigma Brow Duo in medium, but we did have very similar brow shapes, so I did kind of stay with my brow shape as I usually do. I did want to darken them a little bit, which I do feel like this Sigma powder is a little bit darker, which is a reason why I've been loving it because my hair is so dark because of the winter. Thankfully, I'm getting it done soon, but I felt like this brow powder actually really was giving me a darker look because Selena does have black hair, so I did want to make sure my brows were a little bit darker, so that's why I went with my Sigma brow powder. To contour a little bit more, I went with my Kat Von D Shade Light Contour Palette, and I'm using my F40 Contour Brush by Sigma. I went in more with a cool tone of the two powders just because of the fact that the bronze gave me a really nice warm color, so just a little bit of a fact there. So I am just going to go ahead and contour a little bit more. To finish up the eyes, I'm going in with that shade right there. It's more of a grayy kind of browny color, more cool tone. So I am going in and just applying this right to the lower lash line with my E25 blending brush and just messily kind of putting that down, and that is pretty much it, making sure the outer corners are connected so the whole eye look is one. And that is it for the eyeshadows. It's a very simple look, but I I just feel like it looks so glam. So just really, really beautiful. To go off my Tarte Skinny Smolder Eyeliner in Onyx, I am going to go ahead and tight line my upper waterline just to make sure that the lashes look like they blend in a little bit more. Because when I don't do a winged liner, I always go ahead and tight line just because of the fact that I want my lashes to look like they blend in and that they're natural. For liner, you can either go in with none or you can go in with what I'm doing. I went in with the MAC Eye Kohl and Teddy just to give a little bit of a brown color to kind of mix the whole and tie the whole look together. You can either go with nude or this color. It didn't look like she had black or anything, so just keep that in mind. And then to finish off the eyes, I am going in with a coat of mascara to the lower lashes. This is the Girlactic mascara as always, but any black mascara that you have, of course, will do. So now we're going to go ahead and do our face, the rest of our face. For blush, I'm going in with the MAC blush. This is in the shade Sun Bask, and I'm taking my Sigma F10 blush brush and just applying a very soft coat of this blush. It really honestly didn't look like she had too much, but I saw a little bit of color on the cheek, so I am going in with Sun Bask. It's one of my favorites, especially when I wear the color red, either on the lips or in my clothes. So there you go. Like I said in the beginning, Selena's face was so glowy. So I'm first going to go in with the Becca Poured Highlighter in Opal. I'm using this Sigma F04. This is actually a contour brush, but I'm just going to go ahead and apply just a little bit of this highlight onto the tops of my cheeks. Like I said, her face was so glowy. So I'm putting it on the cheeks as well as the forehead. And then to go in and set everything and make this look intense and glowy, I'm going in with my Becca Highlighter in Opal and just apply this all over the face. Like I said, so glowy. I just absolutely love the way her skin look, so I'm just applying that all over with my Sigma F03 highlighter brush. I'm also going to go in with my E46 inner corner brush, and I'm going to go ahead and put Opal down, as well as apply it to the tops of the brows, underneath the brow, I should actually say. Then for lips, I'm actually going to go in with a little bit more glow enhancer because my lips were so dry this day. Oh my god, my face and my lips were so dry because it's just so cold outside. It was so windy this day. It was like, I think it was 35 degrees, but it felt like it was 26. But anyway, I put the glow enhancer down on my lips just to give it a little bit of moisture. And then for lips, I'm going in first with my lip liner by Charlotte Tilbury. This is in the shade Iconic Nude. You guys know it's one of my favorites. I use it all the time. And then for lipstick, I'm going in with a Charlotte Tilbury lipstick, and this is in the shade Nude Kate. When I saw Selena's lipstick, I just was like, okay, that's Charlotte Tilbury. Like, even though it's probably Chanel, in my mind, it reminded me so much of this lip color, and I felt like it was so on point. And then to just add a little bit of gloss, I am going to go in with this Marc Jacobs lip gloss, and this is in the shade Sugar Sugar. And oh my god, I love these lip glosses. They smell so good and I really love them. So after that, your look is complete. I hope you guys enjoy. Like this video if you liked it, and also subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. I love you guys, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye.
Did not watch the AMAs last night, but once I went on Instagram, Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to be doing an Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to be doing a holiday. No holiday!